Hello everyone. So in PBE, let's move on to theorem 7.14. So the statement is, let D be a smooth domain. The Dirichlet problem has at most one solution. B, if alpha greater than or equal to 0, then the problem of the third kind has at most one solution. C, if U solves the Newman problem, then any other solution is of the form V equal to U plus C, where C element of R. So here a domain D is given, which is smooth. So the only condition given here is that the domain is smooth. And so here first part we have to prove that the Dirichlet problem has at most one solution, that is it has a unique solution. And second part is for the Robin problem, that is if alpha is greater than or equal to 0, then the Robin problem has a unique solution. Now we can see that if we prove the B part, that is the Robin problem has a unique solution, then in Robin problem, the boundary condition is a linear combination of Dirichlet and Newman. So if we put alpha equal to 0, we will arrive at Dirichlet problem. So part A follows from part B. Part A is a special case of part B when you put alpha equal to 0. So first we will prove part B. Okay. So we have to consider the problem of the third kind, that is the Robin problem. So the Robin problem is, consider delta U equal to F, that is the Poisson equation for xy inside the domain D, and in the boundary we have U of xy plus alpha of xy dou U by dou N at xy equal to G of xy, that is the linear combination of Dirichlet and Newman. So if you put alpha equal to 0, you will get the Dirichlet condition. So first we will prove for the Robin problem. Now suppose that alpha is greater than or equal to 0, we have to prove that this problem has a unique solution. So first suppose that there are two solutions, U1 and U2. So our aim is to show that U1 is equal to U2. So we take V equal to U1 minus U2. And we see that V satisfies this equation. So delta V is nothing but delta U1 minus delta U2. Since U1 is a solution, we have delta U1 equal to F and delta U2 equal to F. So we have delta V equal to 0. Similarly, for the in the boundary, we have V at xy plus alpha dou V by dou N at xy is equal to so V is nothing but U1 minus U2. For U1 we will get G, for U2 also G, so U1 G minus G is equal to 0. So it means V satisfies the equations, V satisfies the Laplace equation. Delta V equal to 0 for xy in the domain D, and V at xy plus alpha at xy dou V by dou N at xy equal to 0 for xy in the boundary of D. So we got that V is a harmonic function, that is it satisfies Laplace equation, as we got delta V equal to 0. Now we will use, so in the last class we have proved Green's identity 1, 2 and 3. So first we will consider Green's identity 3. So this is a Green's identity 3, integral over D, del U dot del V dx dy is equal to integral over the boundary of D, V dou U by dou N ds minus integral over D, V delta U dx dy. So mark the Green's identity 3 as equation number 1. Now in this Green's identity, put U equal to V. So LHS become integral over D delta V del V dot del V dx dy is equal to integral over boundary. We have, this is V dou V by dou N. Okay. Now what is V in the boundary? So it is in the boundary. So in the problem we have V plus alpha dou V by dou N equal to G. V plus alpha dou V by dou N equal to 0. This is in the boundary we have this condition V plus. So from here V is minus alpha dou V by dou N. So we have substituted here minus alpha dou V by dou N for V. And dou U by dou N is dou V by dou N ds minus integral over D V delta V dx dy. Okay. Now since we have delta V is 0, from here we got V is satisfy Laplace, so delta V is 0. So the second integral, this third one vanishes. So LHS del V dot del V can be written as mod del V square dx dy is equal to minus, I have taken outside. So it is minus integral over the boundary d alpha dou v by dou n whole square ds. Mark this as equation number 2. Now you see equation 1, so you can see the LHS and RHS of equation 2. We see that equation 2, LHS is a non-negative term because delta v whole square is positive. It is a non-negative term. But we see in RHS, this is positive, dou v by dou n whole square is positive, alpha is greater than or equal to 0, but here you have minus, so it means that this is non-positive, okay, but these two are equal, this is non-negative, this is non-positive, and both are equal, which is not possible, hence we conclude that this must be, each term must be equal to 0. So this LHS is equal to 0 implies that this del v equal to 0 in D. Okay, del V equal to 0 in D. Also, we have this term is 0, so alpha dou V by dou N equal to 0 in the boundary. This is in boundary. Okay, so these two conditions implies that, so since alpha dou V by dou N is equal to 0 in the boundary we have V plus alpha dou V by dou N equal to 0. So since alpha dou V by dou N equal to 0, it means that V equal to 0 on the boundary. So we got delta V equal to 0 inside D and V equal to 0 on the boundary. Since delta V equal to 0 inside D, this implies that V must be a constant in D. But V takes the value 0 on the boundary. Okay, so it follows that that constant value must be equal to 0. So V is identically equal to 0, which implies that U1 is equal to U2. That is, if alpha is greater than or equal to 0, Robin problem has at most one solution. So we have proved part B. From this, we can deduce part A. When you put alpha equal to 0, we get the problem as delta U equal to F inside D and U at xy equal to G on D. Now this is a Dirichlet problem. So hence the Dirichlet problem also has a unique solution. Now we will prove part C. Let U1 and U2 be two solutions of the Newman problem. So the Newman problem is delta U equal to F inside D and dou U by dou N equal to G on the boundary. So let W equal to U1 minus U2. Our aim is to show that U1 is equal to U2. Okay. Then again, as we did in the part A, delta W is equal to delta U1 minus delta U2, so it is equal to 0. Dou W by dou N is again 0. It means that W satisfies the Laplace equation, delta V equal to 0 in D, and on the boundary dou W by dou N is equal to 0. Okay, so we got that W is a harmonic function. Now again we use Green's identity 3. So this is a Green's identity 3. In this we put U equal to V equal to W. Okay, so the LHS become integral over D. This is delta V, delta W dot delta W. So mod delta W whole square dx dy is equal to, here again U and V are equal to W. So integral over in the boundary W dou W by dou N ds minus integral over D W delta W dx dy. Now delta W is 0 as W satisfy Laplace equation. And what is W by dou N? Here we have, we also have that dou W by dou N is 0 in the boundary. So this term becomes 0. So the RHS is completely 0. So we got this delta W should be 0. It means that W is a constant function. So let W equal to C. Now what is W? W is nothing but U1 minus U2. So we got U1 minus U2 equal to C. That is U1 equal to U2 plus C for some C element of R. The C is some constant. So if U1 is one solution, that is the solutions differ by a constant. If U1 and U2 are two solutions, then the solutions differ by a constant. Here we need not prove that u1 is equal to u2. Here we have to prove that the solutions differ by a constant. Okay, so the Dirichlet problem and the Robin problem are unique. The solutions are unique. But for the Newman problem, we have to prove that the solutions differ by a constant. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you.